All right. Bless the Lord. I am not going to be on here long tonight. Amen. It's been a minute since I've been on. I haven't done a real teaching in a while. And this isn't a teaching tonight as well. It's just a real short ministry fact scope. Amen. Blessings to you. Blessings to you. Hey, Uriah, I see that you joined. Amen. My wonderful husband, my sister, Overseer Solange, is on with us tonight as well. As I say, I'm not going to be on here long, but this is just something that I've been thinking about all day long. For those of you all that don't know me, I am Tanya Mitchell. I am the pastor of Nothing But the Truth Ministries, located in Clinton, Maryland. I have actually been pastoring since 2003. Amen. And so this year, it will be 13 years that I have been pastoring, but I've been in ministry longer than that. And so there are some things that come with maturity in ministry. Amen. And so I want to share with you some real ministry facts that leaders go through. And one of the things we have to understand is that when you are in ministry, people will come and people will go. It is something that is going to take place. But as ministry leaders, we don't always handle it the right way. Why? Because sometimes it hurts us when individuals that we have ministered to, poured into, nurtured, and things of that nature, they decide to leave. And unfortunately, a lot of times in the kingdom of God, people don't always leave the correct way. But what we as leaders have to realize is that people are going to come and people are going to go. And we often, like I said, don't handle it right because it hurts. And so over the years, I have dealt with that. I can say the first time somebody left my ministry that was very close to me, it devastated me. It really hurt me to the core because the ones that are closest to you oftentimes are the ones that hurt you the most when they actually leave your ministry. And so we have to understand that everybody is not meant to stay in our ministries. Amen. We as pastors, we have to mature enough to realize that some people come to us just to be sent. Amen. We have to realize that there are some people that come that need to be trained up, raised up, and sent out to do the work that God has called them to do. Everybody's not meant to stay there. Will there be some people that will be with you ride or die from the moment you begin your ministry to the moment that you end? Yes. But in reality, there are other individuals that are gifted who have calls on their life, and we are sometimes called to train and equip them. What bothers us sometimes as ministry leaders is that we know the call on your life, but we don't have the opportunity to really equip you and send you the way we would like to, because sometimes people can get impatient. People don't always want to go through the process of what it's going to take or what they need to go through before they are actually sent. But let me tell you, as a pastor, every leader wants the joy of being able to send out somebody that has been in their ministry, nurtured, rooted, and grounded, and you know they're walking out their assignment and call. But again, that doesn't always happen. But there are times when you will be able to see the fruit of your labor. I'll never forget recently. I thank God for his ability to restore relationships. Hey there, Apostle Booker. But I thank God for his ability to restore relationships because I know that I had a husband, a son and a daughter in my ministry. And they were very, very close to me in ministry. I knew that they had strong giftings and things of that nature. And I was actually training them. Bless you, woman. And I was actually training them in some things as it pertained to leadership. They was part of the leadership staff. And for many different reasons, they made a decision to actually leave the ministry. And at that particular time, it really hurt. It really hurt. Sometimes you'll see what takes place in your church, what appears to be like a church split sometime when you have individuals that actually leave your ministry. And so just recently, I had the opportunity to reconnect with the young man and his wife. And let me tell you something. All I can say is God is good. Because even if you know about Paul and John Mark, they had an opportunity when they did not always see eye to eye. And they went their separate ways. They both continued to do ministry, but they went their separate ways. But then there was a time when Paul sent for John Mark because he knew he had need of him. And I thank God because this year, after many years, God has allowed me and this husband and wife team to reconnect. Amen. It was pressing in my spirit, people of God, when I saw the notice that I received from him sharing with me about his 5-year church pastoral anniversary. And it hit my spirit so heavy, and I knew that I needed to be there. Amen. And so I pressed my way out there to that service. And as I'm sitting there, you know, I walk in the door, I see people that I know. I'm excited. He's been pastoring for 5 years. And then finally, before we got far in the service, you know, he came up and he said, "I just need to say something." He said, "I have to give honor where honor is due." And he said, "Pastor Mitchell, I want you to know that what you are looking at right now today is the fruit of your labor. Your labor was not in vain." And you all just don't understand what that meant to me, because in the midst of me sitting there, I'm looking and I'm seeing, you know, how things are actually set up. I know things that I instilled in them and things of that nature. And it was awesome. Amen. Even when I saw some of the people that was out celebrating them in their anniversary service, they too were some of the people that came from my ministry, but they were still doing the things that they were trained to do while at my church. They were still going forward in their giftings, and it blessed my spirit so much, y'all. You just don't know. I was there like a proud mother, and we needed that moment. Me and that pastor, Pastor Quentin Farmer, that's his name, amen, and his wife is Pastor Aisha Farmer, and we needed that moment of restoration. And so, you know, the reality of it is I stood before the people. And I shared to the people, this is his first 5th church anniversary. And this is my first time ever coming to his church. I said, but I knew that I had to be there. But what I told the people is that there are a lot of individuals that are starting ministries that are not anointed and called to do it. I said, but I know the oil on this young man's life. I knew what was on him in my church. Amen. You said, because you are awesome. Oh, and I witnessed that your prayers were. Amen. Amen. And so I knew that he had a call on his life to minister, even to the point I shared with him that while he was at my church, I considered, had a thought about him being the assistant pastor of the church, but I knew I could not share that with him at that moment because he was still a novice. But I knew the call was on his life for ministry. And so I was very proud of that restoration. Amen. We actually haven't done it tomorrow. Me, my husband, and him and his wife. But in ministry, people, what I'm saying is sometimes things happen. And like he said, when he was standing there, things happen. He said he thanked God because I dealt with him. He was most rebellious. He know he dealt with some pride, whatever the case may be. But guess what? As leaders, you have to get to a point where you have to let that stuff go and move forward. And one of the things that we as leaders have a problem with doing is we have a hard time. Amen, Apostle. We have a hard time letting go of people that are valuable to us in the ministry. Amen. There are some people for real, when they make a decision to leave the church or they stop coming, it doesn't affect you that much. Because how many of y'all know some people just show up? Some people just fill a seat. They don't do anything, even to the point of sowing some of them. So they're just there. So sometimes when they transition, it's not as devastating. But when you have valuable people in your ministry, those are the hardest ones to see leave your ministry. But again, people come and people go. And so one thing that I like is when people leave my ministry, it blesses me to know that they're still staying connected somewhere. I don't like for people to leave the ministry and be in a backslidden state out there, not fellowshipping or doing anything of that nature. I may be sad that an individual is gone from my church, but I still want them to be connected somewhere. And so pastors, let me tell you this. When people leave your ministry, and if they left your ministry on bad terms, please do not allow one situation that caused them to leave to undo all the years that they served in your church. All the seeds that they've planted in your church, all the ways that they served and ministry in your church, do not allow all of that to be X'd out because of a possible disagreement that you all had. Because for real, we can get like that. Everything that they did positive goes out the window. But you forget that they was there helping you to find the location, helping you to get the church set up. They was there teaching children's ministry, the youth ministry, doing all these different things in the ministry. But something takes place that causes a division. Now all of their good works go out the window. It ought not be so. Amen. It should not be like that at all. But again, we don't always get to send people out like we want to, but when God does a reconnection, it is a wonderful thing. Now, for those who are the members in the church, I believe that there is a thing called decency and order when it comes down to transitioning, especially if you have played a major role in a church. If you served in ministry, if you served as a leader, you shouldn't just stop showing up at church. You need to have a conversation with your leader about your transition. And another area that I have matured in over the years since pastoring is that when an individual comes to me and they say they believe the Lord is telling them to leave, or they just simply want to leave, then guess what? I'm not going to try and convince them to stay. Why would you want somebody to remain in your ministry that has no heart's desire to be there anymore? So whether you agree or not with them leaving, whether or not you can clearly see that this is not the Spirit of God that's moving them and it's nothing but their flesh, because in some situations, it's just a person's flesh. Amen. Some people, especially my sisters, I've seen in ministry throughout the years that I've had so many women on fire for God, selling out, doing the things of the kingdom. As soon as they met a boo, then everything went out the window. And now all of a sudden, the Lord is calling them to leave and things of that nature. No, your flesh is being stimulated and now you're overtaken by that instead of your spirit. Let's just keep it real. So after 13 years of pastoring, I no longer am in a place where I'm trying to convince anybody to stay. I like the one-on-one conversation. Share your heart with me. If there's anything that I've done, please explain it to me. But if you come to me and you say it is your desire to leave this ministry, then I am going to bid you farewell without an attitude. Because I understand, again, people come and people will go. But it is so important, if you know you have leaders that are there for you, that you are connected to, and they deal with you on a consistent basis, then guess what? Don't send them a text message saying that you're leaving. Don't send them an email. Have a face-to-face conversation with them if you're not in a mega church. Because sometimes in a mega church, you don't even have that a possibility of meeting face-to-face. But it is a thing about order. And so I believe that we need to do things in decency and order. But my main thing tonight is just to share the true ministry fact that people are going to come and people are going to go. And we as leaders, we need to be prepared for that. Some are there for a season to help you with the ministry that you're in. Now, I ain't talking about these super seasonal people now. Because you got some people, their season change every 30 days. So they're here, there, and everywhere. So that foolishness needs to stop. But everybody's not going to be there for the entire time that your ministry is in operation. They will sow seeds. They will plant in the ground. They will help you do the work, but God may move them on. But if you are a son or daughter in a ministry and you trust your pastors, allow them to process you and send you out, because that's something that does a mother or father's heart very, very well, to know that you're going forward. And for real, I know some of y'all are saying, Well, guess what, Pastor? Every pastor ain't trying to do that. They don't want you to be used in your gifts and different things of that nature. Yeah, you do have some leaders that are often intimidated, but you don't need to be under a leader that's intimidated of your gifts. The reality of it is there are too many individuals that have too many things to offer in the kingdom for us to try to keep things under one roof. And so, yes, they need to be processed and then sent out. We have a heart's desire to do that. And if we are putting things on hold sometimes, please know it's because we've been in ministry longer than you. And we often can see that even though you think you're ready, you're not necessarily ready. But if you happen to step out and go forward and the call is really on your life, you'll hit some bumps and bruises and speed bumps along the way. But I believe God will eventually work things out, just like he's done with my son, Pastor Farmer. He's worked some things out and he's going forward and doing what God has called him to do. And it gives me so much joy because I know he came from within the church that I serve. He was an individual that was never in church, never in the whole setup of the church world. But he came, he got rooted and grounded. There was more that I could have done in him to send him out, but things happen. So whatever the issue may be sometimes, if it's God's will, and if you're willing to be mature about a situation and obey God, because I had to obey God. That's not the first time, people of God, that I saw he had an anniversary. I was never prompted in my spirit, because I can tell you in the beginning, I had to get over some hurts. I was never prompted in my spirit at first, but on this one, their 5th year anniversary. Come on, y'all. Somebody talk about grace. See, sometimes we got to be able to extend grace. We need grace, but we got to be able to extend grace. And so I heard the Lord go to the service, and I pressed. And I pressed, and God was trying to do something, and I thank God for it. Amen. And so we just got to grow up, pastors and leaders, because everybody ain't going to be with us forever. Amen. It's just the truth. Just know how to handle it. It's going to take place. Everybody's not going to be there forever. Don't allow yourself to get so deep in your feelings that you undo all that they've ever done in the years that they was with you. Because your own people, can I tell you this? Your own people will be confused if you go from loving and praising an individual to all of a sudden just straight hating them like they're the devil. Something's off. So it will confuse people. Amen. And so we need to be mindful. We learn from our mistakes. So guess what? I've been in ministry going on 13 years, pastoring. Amen. I've been in ministry longer, but pastoring for 13 years. And I can say that over the years, there's some things that I know I could have done differently. But guess what? Learn from my mistakes. I'll be open and honest so that you don't have to make some of the same mistakes that I did. So anyway, that's all I wanted to come on and share. Amen. I pray that you all enjoyed the rest of your evening. And I pray that this mini brief scope helps somebody in some way, shape, form, or fashion. Pastors, we have to do better with releasing people and accepting that some people are going to come and some are going to go. Bless you, Apostle Fuller. Good to see you. Bless you there, Uriah. I didn't get to call you yesterday, but I will touch base. Call me tomorrow. Touch bases with me tomorrow. I didn't get in touch with you yesterday, but forgive me for that. But I'm looking forward to talking to you. All right, y'all. Love you. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Bye-bye.